What's up, guys? Patterson Yarn. Today's FIFA 17 video. So I'm changing up FUT Champions The Rise. It's now is going to be FUT Champions Recap, which I'm going to show you the first 10 games and the last 10 games. I think showing you all 20 games can get a bit, to be honest, it gets a bit boring, especially for me editing it, doing two videos that take nearly 6 hours or maybe more a week. So that's like 12 hours to edit two full videos. I don't think it's working. So this is getting this recap video. You can see my team on screen here. We've obviously bought some players. We bought Man of the Match Son. We didn't buy 9 goal and we packed 9 goal on. There's obviously got some players on the bench. Eriksen, Reed, Dembele. We actually packed Alexandro in the rewards, which I will put a link to in the description or on screen. We bought De Gea as well, which I don't like De Gea, and I wouldn't recommend anyone buying him. He's so overrated in my opinion, where Courtois is like a quarter of the price and does the job a lot better. So this is the team. Obviously, I think everyone gets full chemistry, but Manolas is such, he's a good card. It's just his work rates on me, it lets him down. He's too fast. I know that sounds weird, but he's just too fast. Probably don't believe he's on that, but he's out of position a lot because of his speed. First opponent, nice looking team. You shouldn't give her much trouble, to be honest. Start off Kante, his son, bangs one in the bottom right hand corner. Or left hand corner, because obviously I am colourblind with that decision. So his son passes to Pogba. Which, I will tell you now, I have sold a lot of these players by now. Because I have kind of something I'm trying to do. I don't know if it's going to come off yet. I'm a couple of 100k away from getting the player I want to get, but it pretty much revolves around selling a lot of my players, so I'll just see a lot. And it hasn't come off yet because I'm waiting for my weekly rewards, which will come out on Thursday. And maybe monthly rewards as well might be coming out on Thursday. I'm not sure about that, but it is due to come out soon. Next opponent, he's got Man the Match Stindl, a striker. Seen a lot of people using him as a centre mid. He looks like he's got a very nice card, very high overall defending and stuff like that. So, bit weird with the up front there. I wasn't really sure what to do about that. But we'll start off with Alexandro playing as a striker. No left backs and right backs do on this game. Man the Match Son comes with trumps there again with a nice rebound header. I don't know what that goal was about, kind of weird, wasn't it? But Man the Match Son is not worth his price tag in my opinion. I think he's very highly overrated. He does have the weak foot and some dribbling, but I wouldn't pay the 300k that I'll pay for him. So you can see some nice dribbling with Son here and return back inside. Hummels won't leave him alone there, so we'll just turn back. This is a nice player, this actually. So, I couldn't believe that I didn't shoot the Son there. I thought I did, but I obviously didn't. I was trying to get the win as early on as I can. Well, getting the bronze 2 there isn't that bad. So, since the start of the game, I think the first week, I lost my first game in FUT Champions completely. And then, after that, we haven't lost in the first, I think it's 8 games. We haven't lost in the first 8 games in a while. Next opponent, nice looking team. I don't know why people do this, but they're like, to try and link players up, they'll use someone who is like Kovacic there. They've got his normal card when they could probably just buy his inform and do a lot better job. But they'll buy like Sergio Ramos and then Carvajal, and then they'll have some random player linking up with them, and they don't even like replace him, which I think is kind of weird. This was this guy's problem, yeah, in my opinion. He didn't take the players he should have took off. You can see there in the bottom left hand corner, you had Kovacic not even playing in his position, which is why we dominated him here. You see number 4 there, Kovacic isn't even on screen. Last second he comes in the box, he's just not doing anything. That's why I got rid of him. I had his 84. He was decent enough going forward. It's just he's never there on the defence, to be honest. That's my third win. Next opponent. Look at this team. In form. Man the match. Everything. insane. He's got Giuliano and Jesus. 93 Neymar. I don't know how much that team would have cost them, but it's not overpowered enough for foot champions, is it really? Or is it? His team was very nice, actually. I liked his team. Something you don't see much of, though, is them kind of high. Well, it wasn't really hybrid, was it? It was just random cards put together, but nice looking team. He didn't do much in the attacking sense. He just. I don't know. I don't like Team Lear Marcelone. I don't like Team Lear Dani Alves. Never used any of them, but those don't work. Sun there coming up, trumps again. So Martial passes to Kante and slots one in the bottom right hand corner. Nice looking finish there. He does get one back here with Adriano, who I think came on for a sub. Not sure. He gave away a penalty and he obviously saves it, but we'll score there. I didn't show what happened because it was so laggy and he kind of just tripped me player up, so it was that. Look at that finish here by Mane. He just back heels into the back of the net. Isn't he something finish? I like that he didn't actually use the back of his heel. So we dominated this opponent here. With a team like his, he should not have. Well, I should not have dominated him like that. But team is not everything in FIFA. It is to a player that can use it, but obviously in this case, it wasn't that case. Next opponent, a lot of off-chemistry players, which I think's kind of weird. He tried to hybrid it up a little bit, this just doesn't work. I think he might have thought Cavani played for Lyon, which he also plays for PSG. So he got Jesus there, De Gea. This is why I don't like De Gea there. You can see he parries it straight into my opponent, which I realised he did that a lot. That's why I took him out straight away. I've tried him before, three or four times, just don't like him. Put bad dabs on him there. So we'll pass it into Son, who shoots and gets a rebound to Mane. So, a little bit of advice, watch this free kick, by the way. You go R1 and then. No, he didn't actually pass them. I can't even remember what happened there, but I did score a free kick like that before. I think that Sun card's very good when you come up against an opponent that can't defend. But when you come up against someone who is a confident defender, can cause you trouble. So as he's not very. He is agile, but you've got to have that split second before your opponent to get the ball. And some players just don't have that, and some players do. If they do have it, you can't do anything unless you take a long ranger. Next opponent, nice looking team. What I would say to everyone who is thinking about getting Sadio Mane, his finishing is terrible for me. I don't know what it is, he just can't finish. His pace is very nice, but he still gets pushed off the ball. He's not the complete package. Which his card stats basically show that he is, but he's just not really. He doesn't do it for me. I'm thinking about selling him this team of the week. Maybe try him in a squad or something and then see if he's okay enough to play next week's World Champions. But I'm not sure if he's good enough, to be honest. So there he scores for Eriksen, which is one of my favourite cards in the game. Not as a centre midfield, but as a striker. Then Kante comes up and scores from the opponent there. And then Eriksen again passes to Cuadrado, who leaves De Gea in the dust and scores again. So my opponent actually got back in the game here, which I don't know how he did, because it was like dominating him 3-0 and then suddenly came back and took over possession and everything like that. Which is obviously how the game swings momentum, but he didn't deserve to get 3 goals. They kind of came out of nowhere, to be honest. So we hit bronze 2, which is 6 wins, I believe. Next opponent's got Gnabry, he's got Usman, he's got Costa. Nice looking team. Obviously, that defence is very strong with Manolas and Van Aanholt and stuff like that. I've seen a lot of people use Patrick in this week. We don't know who Patrick is, it's Van Aanholt. So he starts off the proceedings there with Gnabry, who I got me Elite 1 rewards and sold him for 30k. But he's kind of the only German striker with that much pace and quite a high overall, so him and maybe Werner will do a job for him in the straighter position. They will get quite lucky in the 86th minute, but we did have more over, and then Sun in the 110th minute puts on past him to make way. So look at the stats here, 17 shots, 10 on target to his like 5, I think it was. So well deserved for me to win that game. I know it's easy for me to say that when you don't dominate possession and stuff like that, but when you have like, it's such a landslide with your shooting, your passing, your possession, your tackles, your ball control, everything just goes against you in the game. Next opponent had a few want to watch items. Very nice team actually, with Kante and Miranda, very, very solid squad. But so he starts off here with Aubameyang. I don't know what Manolasso's doing. So that's a problem with moving your centre back from out of his position, the right back or left back. Can't do the centre back's job in the centre. So you try and keep your full defence in the position, which is kind of hard when players make overlapping runs into certain areas, but you've got to try and keep that. Sun comes back and puts with 2-1 up in the 20th minute. So Sun has a five star weak foot, which you can tell. And obviously since I scored there, he had an initial pace boost, which I don't know how he got that. He just suddenly turned on the jets to run past my ass. But that's his FIFA for you, isn't it? I think it's so inconsistent sometimes when your opponent scores and then they score straight away and they've like not had a chance in the full game. It just feels a little bit unfair when you work for your goals. That was nice by 9 goal line suddenly. So you see there, Mane's shot, and that was just terrible. For a card that cost me 350k, that was terrible. Pogba takes a long range and scores, and this is just FIFA in a nutshell, that really. If you watch this, De Gea could have picked that up. So that's never happened to me with Courtois, and that's why I got rid of De Gea. So inconsistent, so overrated, so overpriced. I know he does well for a lot of pro players, but he doesn't do very well for me, to be honest. My opponent here did not deserve to even have a chance in the game. Well, not a chance, but to come back in such like a repetitive session, it was like, no, he didn't deserve it. But obviously the stats are otherwise. But it was quite even to a certain extent, just every shot he took, especially the one with De Gea, really like annoyed us. He didn't deserve that. But that's just FIFA for you, to be honest. You can't really get mad about it. I never get mad at FIFA, because it's just a game, to be honest. But once I was mad, I think it was a couple of weeks ago, where I got 36 wins, I do believe it was, and I was top 100 until like, I think it was 10 o'clock, and then I got outplayed. It was like 4 positions or 36 wins, and someone had a higher skill rating than us. I just think that part of FIFA really pisses me off, because it's not my fault someone rage quit, and top 100 prizes are a lot better than other prizes, and to lose out because one of your opponents that you played rage quit isn't very fair in my opinion. But FIFA is a game that is unfair to a certain extent. You start off FIFA with putting loads of FIFA points into your account. So let's just stop that. I'll keep going on that in a second. But why has he reached top 100 there? 86 wins. I don't know why it's saying 2-5. It's obviously a glitch in the thing that normally happens. But top 100, we hit that a lot normally. But I never normally play this early on. This was very early Friday morning, I think it was, which I never play early Friday. I play early Saturday morning and then normally don't play through the day. So I have some kind of, look at this finish by Mertens. What was that? That was disgusting, that. Absolutely disgusting. So Pogba through ball to Mane, who, as with everything, he cannot score a normal shot. He has to make it all free, so. So he has Son do some nice skills and shoots across goal, and Martial's there to hoover it up. He's hoovering it up against Handanovic. So I don't know why my team in line is so high forward. which I don't play like that at all, but I don't know. So he scored the first time effort there with Salah on the bounce, pretty much. I don't know how he did that. I'm sure that was his weak foot as well. So Manolas gets outstrength by Dybala, cuts it back. Smalling goes in, tackles him twice. And then Kalota goes in. Look at that angle. That is 45 minutes at its finest, that. Angle was ridiculous. And then he scores in the 96th minute. We obviously went extra time at that point. And Mertens, it just went with a landslide, really. After he got a chance, he got a chance. Obviously, he didn't deserve to score that many goals. So that was the first loss. And we're going to a last 11 games. Watch, you can see me coin balance at this point. I've sold a lot of my players. And we're working towards Team of the Year Ronaldo. Which, I've never actually had a Ronaldo, a Messi, a Neymar, something like that in any FIFA. I've never played FIFA. I've played FIFA, but I've just never had the coins to get to that point, really. Which I think this year is going to be the year if I get some good in the rewards. Which I think it's very well deserved. I don't say that a lot, but this year in FIFA I've put a lot of time, I've put a lot of effort. And I have actually tried to play a lot of games. I've played over 1,000 games on my account. I obviously traded a lot as well, which I don't do much on the channel, but I can trade very well. Which, the thing with trading is, if it's already out there, it's already broke in my opinion. So I have a lot of tips and stuff like that that aren't out there. And a lot of these other YouTubers that show you tips are already recycled from someone else's video. Just keep that in mind. But the stuff I try and show you, you can't really teach trading off a YouTube video, really, in my opinion. Which I know a lot of YouTubers take the videos like that, but that's their own business. Which, it's got nothing to do with me. But we'll go into the last 10 games here. So I think the idea of changing Foot Champions Horizon 2 videos to one is a lot easier. And it'll come out every Saturday, I think the day is going to be. Just the reason for that is because I want to do my Road to Glory videos like throughout the week and stuff like that. And there's a lot more content on the Road to Glory than the Rise was. The Rise is already... We're starting off with a team on the Rise. We've obviously got this team basically a Road to Glory format before my YouTube channel existed. So I want to show you, obviously the Road to Glory is going very well. It went to episode 4 at this point. We have a solid team. I'm going to tell you now as the video is already up by now probably, but on the Road to Glory, qualified the first time entering for Foot Champions with a terrible team, and I mean terrible. Not full chemistry, not high overall players, just terrible. Really, really bad. I can't believe I qualified, to be honest. But I wanted to do that to show people that you actually can qualify for Foot Champions. If anyone actually wants us to do the Foot Champions kind of how to qualify video, I can do that for you if you want. Because I have a few tips which might help you. And it's mainly due to the time you play. Obviously, there's a big factor in Foot Champions is timing, in my opinion. There's certain times of day I just don't play Foot Champions. This is, you're wasting your time. Player pool is too high, connection is bad, stuff like that. That's another video though, that'll probably be coming out on the weekend. I think I'm going to do that video because I've seen a lot of YouTube videos where it doesn't tell you the truth about what time to play FIFA and stuff like that. Which there is a good time to play, there's a bad time to play. Which will be done in that video. If you want to see that, write something in the comments about the video. And I think it will help a lot of people out. So a lot of people watch my videos because, well, not a lot of people, but some people watch my videos due to I try and help people in FIFA, which obviously you can tell by my gameplay. I'm not top 100, I'm not a pro player. Obviously, to be honest, I'm a Call of Duty, well, I used to be a Call of Duty player and stuff like that, but other FIFAs just didn't have enough content for me. It was kind of boring. Unless you post thousands of pounds on the game, you couldn't get anywhere. So that is pretty much the same in this game. You have to put loads of time into the game to get where I've got. So where I've got in FIFA on the PlayStation, you probably see there's probably bigger YouTubers that are further advanced than me due to certain stuff. Let's see. Obviously, it's easier to share ideas with a community who can give you something back in tips and stuff, and that's how a lot of YouTubers on the road to glory make loads of money, because of the audience telling them who to buy and stuff on Twitter. Which is kind of a cheating way to do, because you're not really making a road to glory then, but that's what they do. I don't know what game when we've kind of lost count of just talking about stuff, but Pro Champions Arise recap will be on Saturday, and Road to Glory will be throughout the week. I don't know about every day, because I do custom tactics videos. I do custom tactics videos throughout the week as well, which are the most viewed on my channel, which take the less time to make, which I don't get, to be honest, but obviously, because I play with a lot of formations in Online Division 1, it's easier for me to show what actually works. I know it's kind of looked down upon to show what are the best custom tactics for that position or formation, because I've seen a lot of YouTubers complaining about people making videos on it, but a lot of our YouTubers have done it a lot worse than me, custom tactics videos, and I don't see it as a problem, and I don't think it is a problem, so that's why I show the best ones that you can get, because no one shows you custom tactics for that formation in just a quick video without them talking shit for 20 minutes. Everyone wants to know what custom tactics you can use, play instructions, get into a game and beat and have the edge on the opponent, which I try and do to a certain extent. So I do believe custom tactics can give you kind of a 10% boost in a certain game, which if you don't have custom tactics on, you don't get that boost. So we'll get our 31st win there, which is Elite 3. And how I started this weekend with the first 9 wins and then 1 loss. And in the middle, it kind of broke down, we got a couple of losses. And then actually in this gameplay, there was one more game to play, but I just didn't play it. Because I was so, not annoyed, but I've done it before where I've tried to play the last game. No, actually, what happened, I did play the last game, was just there was nothing to play for, so I didn't need to win, so I wasn't playing really. I was trying to edit a video at the same time, which doesn't really work. So we lost that game. I think that was, I'm not going to tell you, it'll spoil the video, but that's what was happening there. That's why there's no 40th game, so that's why I put the 29th game was the 11th game, if that makes sense. Probably doesn't, but if you want us to do any videos that help or going to help you personally, write it down in the comments if you're watching this call as well, just so I know who's actually watching the videos. I do appreciate that stuff. This opponent here wasn't very good, to be honest. I don't know how some people in FUT Champions get to certain points. Like, some players are just not good in my opinion. But something else I was thinking about doing on the Road to Glory, if you haven't seen that, it's on my channel somewhere. But the Road to Glory episodes, I was thinking about seeing if I can win, well, not win, but do good with a 5 at the back formation, just part of the bus, and see what happens. So this opponent here, look at his team, it is an insane team. Game 36, by the way. We've got Valencia, Pogba, want to watch Pogba, that's like 1.5 million there. Usman, 100th minute, so we went the whole game without breaking the deadlock. And then we just unlocked something with Usman coming on off the bench, I think he did, and we got a rage quit. Fine by me, because I was getting sick of playing at this point. That's our 33rd win, and here comes our last game in a second. Here is the next team. Look at that team, it's insane. I've seen a lot of people actually inform Manolas is something I was going to buy. I don't know why he had Florenzi right back. I don't know why he's there. Look at that, by the way. Let's just stop and talk about this. 45 minutes in, and look at this, finesse. What is that? Over Courtois, one of the tallest keepers in the game. It just goes flying past him. He has Ali here. De Gea saves it, and Bolasie slots on home. Bolasie saves me so many times off the bench. He's a cheap Ronaldo, no doubt about it. So Hazard scored from the opponent there, which was still 33 wins. That's why at this point I had, like, I think 4 games left to win 2 or something like that. So I left myself room to win, obviously. Next opponent, you see some teams, and you like compare them to your team in your head. You're just thinking, this player's got the edge on me in certain areas, but you can't really go into the game like that, but I do to a certain extent because it helps us mentally figure out what the opponent's going to try and do. You're seeing he had 87 Lukaku there, so I know he's going to try and back up into my defender. And already put myself in that mindset where he's going to back up, and you've seen there he dominated me in that game. But there we go, 34 wins, Elite 1, which is what I've been aiming for a while. I just try and hit Elite 1, which is the best way to play in my opinion. So I don't think we have long left. Let us check how long's left of the video. I can't see, but there's not long left, I don't think. Let's check my computer. I think it's paused. That's another recording. So wait there, let me check this recap video. Oh, that was going on. My bad. So that was the pretty much the end of the video. I forgot to I had another video playing in the background, something like that. But it was lagging the recording. So that's going to be it for today. If you liked the video, hit the like button. I will see you next time. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.